So in order to tell the difference in the metabolic diseases, you need to look at the clinical signs of the animal and pair it with the history of the animal. So you ask the farmer what's been going on, what's he done with this animal, how soon has she calved long, has she had any treatment? And you've got to formulate, got to get all the information together along with the clinical signs to work out what you're going to do and what you're going to treat with. So for instance, with milk fever or the low calcium in the blood, calcium is used by the body, the cow's body, for all sorts of muscles. That means the muscle of the heart, the muscle of the gut, and the muscle of the leg, the musculoskeletal system. And the signs will come on as each of those misses out on some calcium. For instance, in the early stages of milk fever, a cow will be standing and it will have little tremors in its muscle. And that's giving you a sign that something's not quite right. They're not firing correctly. She can also start to become constipated because the gut's not working properly. And she'll even bloat up a little bit because she can't burp up a gas like normal. When they're down, they can get a funny S-shaped bend to their neck, which means that the muscles in the neck aren't working anymore. But the most obvious sign is the failure of the leg muscles to be able to take their weight, and then they end up sitting down. And that's milk fever. Now for grass staggers, it's a little bit different. The magnesium in the blood of the cow is used by the muscle in the cow and also for the nervous system. So her signs when she's getting low magnesium levels tend to be a bit more neurological. She's got a finer tremor. Her eyelids will flutter and flicker. She's trying to walk along, but she isn't quite able to coordinate how she's moving. She'll bump into things. They can also become aggressive. They'll actually chase you out of the paddock. And the last thing, they sit down and then they start to convulse and have seizures. And all these things can lead to death. Same with the milk fever. The other one was ketosis. Now ketosis, there's two forms. There's a wasting form where they become skinnier and their coat gets rough and they don't make as much milk because they don't have the energy to do these things. So they break down their body fat, which then leads them to make more ketones, which makes them sicker, and they chronically waste away. The other form of ketosis is where there's a nervous form. So it's like a toxin. The ketones are like a toxin in the body, and again they have tremors. They don't know what they're doing. They can even be blind. They'll sometimes go up to a rail and chew on the rail and salivate. So there are some subtle differences, but a lot of them are often the same. The tremors, the muscle twitching. So it can be difficult to tell which one is which. For that reason, treatments quite often are based on a combination of the metabolic things they could be lacking in. So we can have calcium, magnesium, and energy, or dextrose, all in one solution to try and cover the bases, all the three different things that might be affecting a cow.